In this video, I want to share with you how to use the Google Office Suite. Okay, so as an alternative to Microsoft Office Suite, that may be quite expensive for some people to access. Maybe Office 365 is too expensive, and you're tired of paying consistently every month for Office 365 package, and you want an alternative. Well, Google Docs is a very Google Office Suite is a very very fantastic tool that is actually for free for personal use. Only for business use you have to pay, but for personal use is quite free. And you can see, build your best ideas together in Google Docs. You can collaborate online and do so much more. It comes in with different kind of features. You can write faster with built-in intelligence, and you can consult, you can bring in collaboration and intelligence to other file types. Okay, so you have different kind of files: PowerPoint, Excel, and Microsoft Word. Okay, so you can do more with add-ons. There are a lot of add-ons that you can add in, work on fresh content, stay productive, and even offline. You can work even offline. So security, compliance, and privacy is secured here. So these are some of the various plans, products that you can find in the Google Office Suite workspace. You have Google Sheets, Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides. These are representations of Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, and Microsoft PowerPoint. Okay, so you have, in addition to that, you have Forms, Keep, Sites, and many more. Okay, so but for now we are going to concentrate on these three, which are the most important: Docs, Sheets, and Slide. Okay, for business use is 12 USD per month, but for personal use, which is the one we are going for, is free. Okay, so for free personal use, you have a bunch of these options. You have 15 gigabyte of Google Drive storage, cloud storage, and you can do Google Meet video conferencing with a maximum of 100 participants. Okay, so let's check out the Google Docs for personal use, which is this one. And over here you have the option to, you can check from these three lines, you have a bunch of other features and options. For example, you can see the different features, okay, the docs, the sheets, the slides, and forms. So you can navigate to each and every one of them from here directly by just clicking on these three lines. So let's say we start with the docs, and we've got a number of templates that we can start from. So once you open the Google Docs, you can get there from maybe this, from these three lines, or you can come to docs.google.com. Okay, so once you're here, you'll be hit with a start new document, maybe from a template, depending on what you want. Is it a resume? Is it a letter? Is it a project proposal? You can all start from here. These are templates, and these are recently used documents from your computer. It's going to capture that, and you can see quite a lot of them. But then let's say for this tutorial, we are starting at the blank page. Okay, so we'll click on this to start a blank page. And once you're here, the first thing you will notice is that you can start typing immediately here. And the first thing is to give this document a name. You can rename it over here. So let's just call it public speaking. Okay, so you give it a name, and it's going to save this on your drive. Okay, so it's going to save it to the drive. You can always visit it to check, and you can mark this as a start document, so you can easily find it even within the start document in your Google Drive. So you can write anything as usual, and you can call out people depending. Okay, and you have a bunch of options over here from the ribbon. You can type anything, whether you copy and paste or you type. So let's say we type something: welcome to Epic Mentorship. Please remember to subscribe. So this is just something, a text that we just type. You can select it, and you can play around with the text over here. We have the text editing features. You can align center, you can align right, you can align left, you can kind of justify if you want. You can change the line and paragraph spacing, and you can change many other features, just like the way you have in Microsoft Office. You have equally have it over here. You have the editing features, you have suggesting, you have viewing. Okay, people who you want to collaborate with, what can they do on this document? Okay, so you have other options here. You can undo, redo, you can print, you can do all sort of things. You can put in the text style, normal text, you can increase the size, you can put headers, and many more. You have the font style and font types over here. You're free to explore and check it out. Over here you have the file. You can start a new document, either it is a Microsoft Word document from a template, or you can start a spreadsheet, or you can start a presentation, or even drawing from here. Okay, so you can open an existing document or make a copy of it, and you can email this to someone, email this file to someone directly, or you can download on different formats, PDF, .docs format, rich format, or plain text. Okay, so much more. You can move this file to another file or content or place in your Google Drive, or you can move it to trash, and so much more. So you have the other editing features like copy and paste, do and undo, redo, and view options. You can customize this to your liking. You can enable mode, editing mode, and you can enable on the suggestive mode like we've explained. You can enable full screen or show section breaks easily. You can insert different kind of things from here. You can insert, upload a document, an image from a computer, from a search the web to find a document, either Google Drive or Google Photos, or enter a URL and to capture that picture. And you have tables. You can insert different kind of tables using different kind of rows and columns and all that. You can insert all sort of things. You can insert drawings also. You can create a new drawing. You can insert different kind of charts, bar chart, column charts, line charts, pie charts, and many more. Or you can even insert from Google Sheets directly. Okay, so you could bring in horizontal line dates, footnotes, special characters, equations, watermarks, and headers and footers. Okay, page numbers, you can add all that easily from here. You have a bunch of formats. Okay, text paragraphing, you can use the text features over here, bold, italic, underline, and so much more. And you can equally do that using these various controls, Control B, Control I, and Control U, just like the way we have it in Microsoft PowerPoint or Microsoft Office Suite. Okay, so you have a bunch of headers and footers, and you have a bunch of tools, spelling, grammar, word count, and all that. Feel free to try it and see. You can even do voice typing. You can hit on voice typing and you can start typing. So click to speak. So let's say we want to type it here. As soon as you identify the place, you click to speak. Hello and welcome to Epic Mentorship. Please remember to subscribe to our channel, and you can stop it, right? You can see this is, you've just said something and it has written it for you. You can do that consistently and continuously using this feature. Okay, so you have a bunch of features. Try other things. You can do formats, you can check out tools, script editor, preferences. You can bring in different kind of add-ons, do more with add-ons. You can get add-ons and apply them here. So one of the most important part of this document, Google Docs, is that it comes incorporated with different kind of apps. For example, at the top here you have the calendar, which you can easily use to check your activities and your schedules for the day easily. You can check based on your activities what and what do you have for today, what and what do you have for the week. You can even check out, this is today, Monday, I don't have anything. Maybe you can check yesterday, what do I have. You can see to update it over here. Okay, and you can open it in a new fresh tab so you can have an idea of what and what do you have. You can check on each day what activity do you have and at what time easily. Okay, and over here you have Google Keep. Also, you can check out your document and data that you've kept because it will synchronize with your Gmail address easily. Okay, so you have the contacts, maps, and many more. And you can bring in other add-ons also from here. One of the key important feature of this is that you can share easily with your friends, privately to your friends, so that they can contribute and collaborate with you while you are working on this very document. So it's very easy to do that. Feel free to try it and experience it. It's a very fantastic alternative to Microsoft Word. So let's say we are trying another option, which is we open spreadsheet and take a look at how it's going to look. And as you can see, it looks perfectly the way we want it to look, because it kind of looks exactly like the Microsoft Excel look. Okay, it looks like exactly like the Microsoft Excel that we have. You see the cell arrangement, okay, and the different features, okay, the file menu, the same thing, edit menu, you can have the same editing features, you can have the same view options, okay, you can have insert, you can bring in different kind of cells, you can insert cells and shift right, and insert cell and shift down, okay, You can insert rows, you can insert columns, you can insert sheets, and even charts. You can bring in pivot tables, images, and even drawings. Okay, you have different functions you can check around over here, and easily you can use them. Okay, so you have formats, over here, you have different themes you can bring in, and you can text features, different text features, alignment and wrapping, rotations of text, and all that. You can check around and see how and what you can do with your text. And data tab also contain all sort of things, from create a filter to filter views, add a slicer, and so much more. You can have tools over here, you can create forms directly from here, you can do spell check and notifications, and you have a bunch of other extensions that you can check around, the macros and all that, app sheets you can check, and you have the help menu also that is available at any given time. Over here to these tabs, you have various bunch of features that you can use to plot your graphs and to edit your text and play around with the text styles and all that. You just feel free to try it. These are functions that we've just explained. You can just check through it and see what you can benefit from. And over here at the top, you can share the document equally with people, and you can upload and publish. You can present this using this icon to the people. You can present using a meeting code, usually on Google Meet. You can easily present this on using the meeting notes. So this is just the same way that you have, the same way that we have in the Microsoft Excel. Just feel free to try it and see what you can do. How can you edit? How can you play around with your document? What benefits can you have? So the same way, you can try to open the Google. We'll come back here and save to file and say presentation instead of spreadsheet. You can say presentation, and you have the looks just like the way you have in Microsoft Excel, and you can do quite a lot with these presentations as well. So the same way you add slides, the same way you add content to your slide, the same way you change the theme, the backgrounds, the arrangement, the slideshow, virtually many of those features are also available over here. So one of the key advantages or additions that we have over here is a theme that's newly introduced. You can see different kind of styles that you can bring into your themes, to your slides, so that they can kind of look much more professional and better. So feel free to try it, to explore and see. So whichever one you click is going to take that as a template, and you're free to add content accordingly, and you can just type anything you want, for example. So many things you can write, and you can customize this to your liking. You can close this, and you can check other features like the background, the layouts. You have different kind of layouts that you can bring in, the themes that we just discussed, transitions. You have a bunch of transitions you can check. From here you can see a lot of them dissolve, fade, but the only downside of presentation is that the Google presentation is that it doesn't have much of the animations compared to what we have on Microsoft Office 365 and all that. Okay, so all the features you can find them virtually here. You can have the view, the edit feature, the view feature, the insert feature. You can insert so many things accordingly, just like we've explained. The formats, you can play around with the text formats, slides format, you can bring in new slide, duplicate slide, delete slide, and so much. Transitions you can apply, you can check out the arrangement order, you can bring in top to bottom tools, you can just check out the spelling tools. Voice speaker also works here as well. You can bring in different kind of add-ins and many more. Okay, so feel free to try the Google Office suite, including the Microsoft, including the docs, the sheets, as well as the presentation. They are very, very good alternatives to Microsoft Office suite. If you're tired of that, you can always use this. And once you're done editing or presenting or making your document, you can always come to file and you can always download this in different formats. That's one of the benefits. Once you download it in .ppt, this is going to open in the Microsoft PowerPoint anywhere you find yourself. Equally the same here, once you download in .docs, is going to open in Microsoft Word equally, and you can download even in PDF, which can open virtually anywhere. The same thing goes to this spreadsheet. You can download in different kind of format, .xls or .pdf, okay, or .csv. It's still going to open in Microsoft Office Excel and thereabouts. So ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit about Google Office Suite. If you like this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.